Kenyans. I want to introduce myself to you. My name's Joseph Jirohewa Munene, a Kenyan resident residing in Sweden, a real Mzalendo. I'm here to tell you about the formation of National Restoration Front. It's a movement that I've started here after a collaboration with my fellow Kenyans who really love their country. And they are here with me. There are so many things that we have in mind. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce to you the chairman of the National Restoration Front, Mr. Gethuku Wamwirani, who is here to tell you more about the movement that we have formed here in Sweden. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
Thank you, my fellow countrymen, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gethuku Wamwirani, and I'm the chairman of the Kenya National Restoration Front. Our movement is born out of what has been happening in our country in the recent times, because we have seen the situation in our country degenerating into a situation whereby chaos is taking over in our country. And we, as the citizens, a responsible citizen of that country, we are decided that our forefathers, what they fought for our country, the freedom fighters, the Mau Mau freedom fighters, and that's why we are saying our country should be restored to the beginning of our independence, whereby our forefathers, they fought for all the four pillars of our country, whereby Kenya is a one unitary country, and we will never allow, so long as we live, that our country to be ruled by chaos and no respect for human rights and the rule of law. Our fathers, our founding fathers in Africa, people like Kwame Nkrumah, Patrice Lumumba, Thomas Sankara, to name a few, they have fought for our African continent and also in Kenya, that as an African country, we should decide our things in our own African way. We cannot allow people to be moving to capital cities of the Western countries, trying to solicit support from our former colonial masters, because what is happening now is like what happened in 1884 during the Berlin Conference, whereby Africa was partitioned and named to be colonies of certain and few African European countries. This time around, we cannot allow that to happen. So, my fellow Kenyans, what is happening today and this movement whereby it's born is because after the consultation we had in Kenya when we were there recently, and we had consultation from all the 47 counties, we, the 48th country, which is the diaspora county, we are hereby saying that and stating that Kenya is going to remain a one unitary country, and we're going to follow the rule of the law and the Kenyan constitution, which is supreme, and we won't allow anyone to profile a certain community or to make one community feel as if they are not part and parcel of that republic, because Kenya belongs to all the more than 44 tribes or communities in Kenya, and whereby also people, they cannot disregard the rule of law, and yet they pretend that they are the fathers of democracy. That one we will never allow and we will not accept. So today we are calling all the other 47 chapters in Kenya to be active and to realize and to start talking to our members and our fellow citizens that our country was fought and paid by the blood of the Kenyans. We won't spill any other blood this time around. Those who are calling that for people to resist, they should resist violence, they should resist hatred, they should resist ethnicity, they should resist what is so-called the profiling of other communities. We are resisting also the so-called profiling of other communities. So we're gonna collaborate and work with the like-minded Kenyans, and that's why at the moment, because the current ruling party is the one which has respecting the rule of law, we are ready to work with them right now. And anybody else is welcomed to join our movement, whoever think that the Constitution is the supreme. And now, my ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce the chairman of the Jubilee Scandinavia, Mr. Kenneth Wamburi. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much, Comrade Mwirani, for that good speech of introduction to the Kenya National Restoration Front. I, as a chairman of Jubilee, would like also to recognize our secretary, Honorable Jenga, is here, and also Honorable Councillor Mwaura is here. And I would like, first of all, to condemn what is happening and the violence that we are experiencing in our country, propagated by the leader, its leader, Raila Odinga. I want to mention the name Raila Odinga because he is the one who has made sure that Kenya is going to stay unstable. Kenya was peaceful before he returned from the United States, where he had gone to serve his masters, where he had gone to sell out his country. And to me, I think that the opposition in Kenya wants to stay relevant to politics. And by them trying to stay relevant in Kenyan politics, they are trying to cause chaos so that they can, you know, uplift themselves to look like they have an agenda. Kenya today is a democratic state. People are abusing the president without them being jailed. Kenya is not like the way it was during 1980s, 1982. Kenya has been a democratic country which has been moving forward. Kenya has been an economically gaining country today. We are seeing development in all corners of our country, electricity, infrastructure, development, and we have seen that we have newfound wealth. Our president, Uhuru and Ruto, are the dream team that Kenya wants. And believe you me, even if United Nations or The Hague, or even Donald Trump himself comes and runs an election in Kenya, Jaramogi can never win over Uhuru at any given time. Uhuru is the Kenyan's choice. We are going to make sure that Uhuru stays in power because that's the will of the people. Anybody who's trying to impose himself in power in Kenya is going to face the wrath of Kenyans today. And as a Jubilee chairman, we are going to support and work with the Kenya National Restoration Front. We support its ideals because it's not calling for violence. It is calling for the restoration of the four corners of our country. I don't want to go much more deeper. Kenyans are peaceful people. Kenyans are really intelligent people. And Kenyans really want peace this time. And that is what we are going to provide. Thank you very much. And right now, I want to introduce European patron, Honorable Daniel Mwaura Juguna, to come forward and also highlight us on what the situation is in Europe. Thank you very much and see you soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Comrade Kenneth Wambure Munge, the chairman of Jubilee Scandinavia. As you have introduced me, I'm Councillor Daniel Mwaura Juguna, erected here in Stockholm, Arbe Bushirika. I need to point one or two things. I'm very happy that we, the people of Kenya in diaspora, have come forward to talk and tell the world the truth about our country. There have been misfortunes and mass misinformation about our country, Kenya. A lot of people have been reading in social media, in our Kenyan newspapers, who have totally been bought by the bourgeoisies to write the negative impact of the Kenyan situation as we talk. I, with my comrades here, we are in Kenya recently. We voted for Honorable Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. We were there in August. We did the same. We have been victimized as the one who are bringing violence. The opposition read by the blood sucker, Raila Omoro Odinga, a person who thrives in poverty, want Kenyans to live in poverty, want to shed blood so that he can get what he wants. And knowing very well that he messed up by not participating in the last elections, now he wants to bring chaos. And I'm advising the government of Kenya today, with my comrades here, that we have to restrain from our attacks here and there. There are going to be many. Our Kenyans have been called by people from America, Europe, and the like, Latin America and in Kenya, asking why is our president so silent? Why can we not? We have young people. We can mobilize to counterattack these fightings, these killings. Yesterday, a policeman, aged 22, was killed brutally by these thugs, calling themselves Nasa, who are bloodthirsty to get Kenya into chaos. And I'm asking my Kenyan countrymen, resist and resist. And I repeat again, resist to these killings and resist the Nasa fraternity who want to destroy Kenya. We have built Kenya. Kenya has been glorified as a peaceful country in the whole of East and Central Africa. Kenyan economy has been growing. It has been destroyed by the so-called opposition. I ask my fellow Kenyans, watch the movement of these people who proclaim to be bringing democracy. And democracy we have. No any other country in Africa has democracy of expression. Today you can criticize the President of the Republic of Kenya. You can criticize the judiciary. You can criticize even Mwaura himself without me doing anything, because we have been given all the resources. Kenya is the only country in Africa for the first time that an election has been nullified by the court in Kenya. And the president came forward to say that I don't agree with this situation, this judgment, but because I believe in constitution, I'm going to live in it. We went to 26. These people thought that they are going to fight this tribal card they have been using, 41 against 1. And now it was supposed to be 40 against 2 tribes. Fighting Kikuyus, fighting Kalenjins. But it backfired from the beginning. And that is where we are. People from Pokot, from Mombasa, Northeastern, all corners of the Kenya voted for Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. And what we are asking is, why are these people in opposition want to bring violence in Kenya? One word. Peace, and we want peace. We have a president elected, and I hope the Supreme Court this time around is going to live with its own foot, because I listened the whole scenario. The petitioners, the government side, the other side, and you can't read, if I can, I'm not a lawyer, but I can read between the lines. The case was weak. And the opposition knew that. And that is why they are profiling violence, so that they say that it is the government cannot rule in this way, because they are feeling that they were cheated by their own lawyers. One led by James Orengo. He did a good job with his lawyers, but he cheated the opposition that if we do this, we are going to get this. Now it's gone, it is water under the bucket. Now Uhuru has been told to be sworn on 28th. And I hope that this will bring peace. And my word, as I supported this movement, which has been formed here by my comrades, Uhuru has to make sure that he's not silent. There's nobody. Moore is not above law. Muirani is not above law. Ken is not above the law. Jenga is not above law. Manzoro is not above law. Any Kenyan, including me, who bring violence in Kenya, should be in committed maximum prison. And with that very few remarks, I wish to say that I support this movement that has been formed, so long as it's going to preach about peace, peace in Kenya, and peace in the world. And I want any Kenyan with sober mind to support this movement and all friends of Kenya, here in Europe, America, and in Kenya. And we are going to roll this movement in Kenya. We want to move it because we are peace-loving Kenyans. And we hope that everybody, Kenyans, you are going to support us. Thank you very much. Thank you, Kenyan. God bless Kenya.
Thank you, Bwana Kanyo.